up right now with one of the most critically acclaimed artists of all time and whatnot, man. You can talk about Basquiat. You can talk about Van Gogh. You can talk about what are them other, you know what I'm saying, Italian.
Picasso. Banksy.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. You can do all that and whatnot. But then my second guest that's coming up, you can also talk about him, man. You know what I'm saying? He's one of the more unsung boxers of all time and everything. You know what I mean? He done trained myself, got my ass whooped. He done trained Black Thought of the Roots, got his ass whooped and whatnot. And he's in here today, you know what I'm saying, with the same kind of eye that I got, because he got his ass whooped. Y'all give it up for Uncut and Eric Kelly!
Hey,
y'all drinking today? What's happening?
Shit, I don't drink, but I had some of this.
Yeah, yo, get you a top pop, man. Yo, I'll cut you drinking through that.
Matter of fact, my hoes drink, so I can take up, you know.
Man, you can definitely have that one that we drunk out of already.
Nah, I'm British.
Take that for her right now. That's all you, the rest of it. You can have the rest of it, man. Yo, so let's start over. Uncut, man, I met you first, man. Bottom line, you know, we've been in the studio together because he ain't just an artist, but he's also an engineer and a producer and everything. How did you get your start, sir?
Wow, which start? Because I have a lot of starts.
You got a lot of starts, man. Let's talk about the producer first. Is the producer come before the art, or the art comes before the production?
Well, the funny thing a lot of people don't know is that there was a casting directing thing that came before all that. Actually, what a lot of people know, my first movie I worked on was Belly.
The first movie you worked on was Belly?
Belly.
Belly, doing what?
Casting director.
You casting direct Belly?
I was a casting assistant.
Who you put in Belly?
I was a casting assistant. That was my first intern job as a casting assistant.
Okay.
That was on Belly, yeah.
Okay.
And then from there I went on casting.
No, you can't just jump over no shit like that, bro. Does he have us on Pennies and Needles or am I tripping? So who you assisted on putting inside Belly?
Well, you know, I don't know if you know Winston Sinclair. She actually was the
Who that?
Winston Sinclair. Winston Sinclair. She's like the casting.
Who that?
Winston Sinclair.
Who was he in Belly?
Winston Sinclair. She's a casting agent. She's who I worked for.
Oh, okay.
So she
worked. Who she put in the shit?
Everybody that, I mean, all the extras, everybody, 5 miles and
under. Well, fuck that shit. Let's go on back to the art then. We can't get you to take no good credit on this shit. You scared of them niggas. Hey. Let's talk about this art, man. Hey, yeah. I actually worked with Uncut inside the studio before. And like I said before, he is an excellent producer, excellent engineer, and whatnot. We have about like at least 15 songs that would never come out and whatnot, but yeah, he made me sound like a real rapper and whatnot, man. Y'all give him a fun cut for that. But his passion and his main focus is
it's
the arts and whatnot.
Yes. The art is 3 years old.
Say it again, sir?
It's 3 years old. That's how long I've actually been focusing on the art, 3 years
okay,
old.
Okay, okay.
And the first thing I came out was the Michael Jackson, which I don't know if you guys know, it was like all over New York and it was posted by a lot of different celebrities and a lot of different people. And
he got to talk through a mask, so you know, you got to.
Matter of fact, I'll take this off.
Man, take that shit off, man.
We're talking a whole bunch of shit.
Y'all thought I was going to be nice. Y'all really thought I was going to show my face?
You still can.
All right. Nah, but pretty much Michael Jackson was the first thing I came out with, and I started doing a lot of street art and putting it all over Philly, New York, L.A. And from what I hear, you can't come in here without bringing a gift. So I made you a special.
Money and violence ain't bring me shit just so
that. Yeah.
They ain't bring me no pistol. They ain't give me no money. None of that shit.
So I made you a special one of the kind, Michael.
No, man.
Cause I know you're a thriller, man.
No.
You know what I'm saying? So
Michael, no,
and I put the star in his eye, so that way you know.
Put the star in Michael Jackson's eye, bro.
yeah, just for you.
Hey, man, you making me feel like a Jackson right now, bro.
Nah, this is just one of the plaques.
Hold on, time out. I'm seeing like a little like inside of his hair. These are actually pictures of Michael Jackson in his ad and things that's from his music.
Oh, so you know this. Okay, so that's the basic of my art. It's art within art.
Look at his hair.
Oh, that's the album.
Yeah, it's the albums and all. Yo, this guy's talented.
Thank you.
Look, what, and see, yo, and people like, I don't know what to do with my hat at that.
Yeah. I'll hook it up.
Let's see it on the Bullsh side.
Pass that other one.
This one here? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, this one hard. That one hard right there. That one hard.
So that's basically my art. It's pretty much a lot of different pieces. And it's all handcrafted. And it's ruby dust on here, red ruby. And they're kind of expensive because they take a lot of time to do. It's like, this is actually, this takes about a week to 2 weeks. It's actually like making a record. You know, first you gotta think of the concept, and then you gotta think of putting the idea together from start to finish. Then you gotta draw it out, sketch it out. Then you gotta go in the studio and actually lace it out, which is paint it, and then you gotta wait. It's a process. So if anybody asks why my stuff is expensive, because it's a process. And I know it's gonna be worth a lot of money in the future because that's my MO, and that's how I'm working hard towards being one of the best out there.
You deserve it. That's amazing right there, man.
And yeah, this right here, it's my baby right
here. Y'all give it up for protecting your heart. Put a condom on your heart.
Yeah, for real. This is my baby right here. This came out like about a year ago. And the concept behind it is pretty much, like I look around and it's a lot of people that just do a lot of mind things and just think before they just do things before they think, and I'm not saying think with their mind, I mean think with their heart, their authentic heart. You know, people quick to do things that they hear and things that they see, but they don't do things that they feel, which is the original, them being themselves. So the protect your heart concept comes behind protecting your true self, your authenticity, you know what I'm saying? So instead of copying or trying to be like, trying to be you, you know what I'm saying? And then at the same time, when people start protecting their heart, it's more like, makes it easier for people to communicate with each other, you know, because you're not in no competition with nobody. You're actually happy to see the next person doing what they love to do. And you ain't got nothing to say, but you happy? Word, do it. You know what I'm saying? So it's more like eliminating the hate without focusing on it. You know what I'm saying? But focusing on the positive type shit.
Man, hey, yo, I appreciate you for that. Y'all give it up for this brother doing positive. What do people find your art, man? Because I want to buy some. And everybody in here, inside camera land, and in the audience want to know what can they get this shit.
Well, I got to protect your heart on Instagram. It's protect your heart. And my IG is UncuttArt. That's UncuttArt. And I sell art on there, and I travel everywhere. I do walls. I got a couple of murals in Miami, 40 foot or better. Actually, I got two murals in Giant Stadium. If y'all go to Giants game, if y'all go inside one of them clubs, I got two big ass mules in the Vacada, one of the Vodka lounges or whatever. But there's one big city on each side. And
how does that feel?
To have mules everywhere?
Yeah, inside the Giants.
It's cool. That's not my destination.
Ooh,
you know,
man,
but it's cool.
On that.
You know,
it always gets bigger.
Yeah, because the thing about things that people don't understand, like, and a lot of artists tell me, like right now, for example, like I'm on a journey. You know what I'm saying? And when I'm on a journey, I got a destination. So all of this is part of the journey. So I'm not here to stay. You know, so anything that happens is like, psh, that's part of the journey.
I can dig
you know
it.
What I'm saying? So nothing gets me down because it's not my destination. So if it don't happen, so what? That's not my destination. That's just part of the journey. So I just keep it pushing. You know what I'm saying? So everybody keep pushing.
Word. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Uncut. Scared little boy named Uncut. And he's been hurt.
Uncut who? I ain't cut Jay-Z though. Undid cut Jay-Z.
Okay.
The other un stabbed Jay-Z, not uncut.
Oh, that ain't got nothing to do with you.
No, it don't.
Do you get that all the time?
I damn sure do. Like, my name is Un. Yeah, you stabbed Jay, bro.
Over Charlie Baltimore?
Real? Nah.
Some of them know the story, some of them don't. Some of them too young for that.
Yeah, there's a lot of stories that we know.
It is what it is. Hey, y'all get up for Uncut one more time. Thank you very much. Uncut, I want you to stick around, man. We're going to go over to my man, Eric Clare, Kelly and whatnot. My what boxing up, what trainer.
What up, boy?
Man, you got my ass whooped, bro.
Nah, you got your ass whooped.
Hey, man, what happened to me, bro?
Let me tell you what happened. This idiot come to the gym the day of the fight. He didn't train not all before the fight. Right. The day of the fight, said, yo, we got 2 hours.
You should've went late. You went a week before the fight.
Nah, motherfucker. You booked me a week before the fight.
Okay.
You came the day of the fight. That motherfucker whooped your ass. You had me. Yo.
Then, yo, at the fight, you said, I am.
That you had him the first, you had, listen, you had him like the first 30 seconds.
First 30 seconds.
And then you got tired.
I got tired. It was a
fat.
Hey, what I learned about a fight that day fat. Is. A boxing match and a fight is two
it's two
things.
Totally different things. You thought you'd just go in there and swarm him and just get him out of there.
Yeah, and
all he had to do was keep his hands up and block, and then you're going to get tired, and that's what he did.
And that's all he had to do.
And just keep his hands up and block. And then you, actually, he ain't beat you, you beat you, because you
I whooped my own ass.
Yeah, you punched yourself out.
I punched myself all the motherfuckers.
Dude, did you see that Instagram, that 50 post that you saw 50 put up?
Hey, man, let me tell you something. I didn't even understand how 50 knew I got my ass whooped.
Listen, 50
he
crazy.
He called me in the middle of the night.
He asked
me, was I right. I talked to Eminem that night.
Yeah.
He called me.
Everybody called you. I'm saying you got me looking fucked up out there.
So. I almost fucked your career.
You got me looking fucked up. You got me looking fucked up out there.
Hey man.
Son, the fucking what was it? TMZ there? Fucking like you got me fucked up. Yo, I forget all the outlets.
Yo, it was Global Grind.
Global Grind.
It was XXL.
Yeah.
We even had ESPN.
Flex out, yeah,
Flex
ESPN.
Trust.
Yo,
all kinds of
you
shit.
Got me looking crazy out there.
Yeah, hey, what did I do wrong?
Everything. Everything. You put your ego in front.
I did.
You okay. Say, okay, I'm big and fat. I'm going to knock this motherfucker out. That's actually, no, the fact that you're big and fat is not actually a plus. That's a negative. It's real nigga shit. Fat, listen, it's not a plus, it's a negative.
Do you want to see me do this shit again?
I would love to see you do it again. And we're going to do it again. But, it's going to be a contract involved.
Okay.
Got to be a contract involved. You got to come to the spot at least 4 times a week to get that work in.
Okay.
At least to get that work in.
For how long? Yeah. How long before I'm ready for my first fight?
Camp is like 8 weeks. Campus 8 weeks.
8 weeks?
Yeah.
And I'll be you
I mean, if you're not willing to donate 8 weeks to keep a motherfucker foot out your ass, then I don't know what you got. It's fucking worth it. And then it ain't like say somebody's got their ass whooped around the corner. Nah, motherfucker, this shit is on ESPN. The whole world know you got fucked up. You know what I'm saying? Your shit like
you
Jack Thriller. Huh?
When did you know it was over for me?
When you had him on the rope and you hit like 4 or 5 punch combo and then you backed up. He didn't even back you up. You backed up and said, oh. I said, oh shit. Yo, I had the water for you. I start drinking the fucking water. I had to resuscitate my motherfucking son. Shit, you got our ass whooped, motherfucker.
Hey, do you remember that moment in the fight where I tried to run back and get some water?
Yeah, when you trying to run, what the fuck are you doing? Yeah. Yeah. That was the little last sip left. I was pissed off he knocked that shit out your mouth. That was the last sip.
Hey, let me tell you something. So, I'm getting my ass whooped for the whole... Like
when, right up here in the Bronx. I don't even know why you come here in the Bronx. They obviously don't fuck with you in the Bronx.
They don't fuck. They don't fuck with you in the Bronx. Like, rounds are like 2-minute rounds, right?
3-minute rounds.
It was 3 minutes.
Like three-minute rounds.
After the first 30 seconds.
Yo, my son couldn't last a minute. Like, yo, he was sucking up all the air in the motherfucking building, yo. I'm for real. He was fucking done.
But how long does the average fight last? Like, I'm talking about in real life.
In real life, 30 seconds, if 30 that.
30 seconds. That's what I was prepared for. Yeah. I beat niggas' ass in my regular life.
Yeah, but I'm saying, man.
All the time.
See, that's
what's the difference?
Shit, it's not the same at all.
Man.
When you whooping somebody's ass and shit, You know what I'm saying? Normally, you kick the shit out of
And the
out
sad
of
part about it is the motherfucker you got your ass whooped by got knocked out the week before. He had just came off an ass whooping. He had just came off an ass whooping.
So he was happy to, let load on
That
somebody.
Nigga came up on you, son. You a come up.
Hey,
he had just got his ass whooped the week before.
He was like, yeah.
How many fights has this nigga had?
He had a few fights. He had some fights.
How many fights have I had?
That was your first fight.
That was my first motherfucking fight.
Yeah, but you
it's
came
like
to the
gym. Basketball with a
my son,
kid.
You some came to the gym drive. 6 hours. You came to the gym 6 hours before the fight. Said, yo, we got to go to the Bronx. You came to the gym 6 hours before the fight to train for a fight.
Right.
Yeah, like the B. Everybody know about the BX Fight Club that they had. Shouts to my son, hold BX Fight Club, but. You came 6 hours before the fight to fight. You got 50, you got Remy Ma, everybody and everybody part of BS Fight, Fat Joe, Pat, everybody, and then you gonna and show up and get embarrassed in front of all these people.
I wouldn't be embarrassed.
Piss me off.
I was embarrassed. I was definitely
embarrassed. And the sad part about it is I ain't even charged the motherfucker.
You charged me for that ass whooping?
Yes. Cause I took an ass whooping too, shit. I don't want to get fucked up for free.
Yeah, man. Let me tell you something. Let me tell you how this nigga turned his back on me after I got my ass.
Fast.
Okay, so I'm quitting the fight in the second round.
Yeah. Fast.
I quit in the second round. You know why I quit? I wasn't scared. I couldn't move my arms.
You were getting your ass whooped. That's why you was quit. You couldn't even block.
I couldn't move my legs no more.
Yo, look at this motherfucker in the back. Yo,
man.
Yo, come here, son.
Where is this fight at?
He brought you to the gym the day of the fight. That's him.
Yeah,
he brought you to the gym the day of the fight.
Where's this shit at?
Hey,
BX Fight Club.
Yeah,
is it online somewhere?
I don't know. It's online.
I'm gonna tell you some funny shit.
Yo, this motherfucker.
This how fucked up my ego was. After the fight, we go to go get something to eat. And we drink a couple beers. He told me don't get no beers before the fight.
Yeah.
I had got a couple beers and shit and whatnot. I thought I could handle it because I really thought I could whoop this nigga's ass. I didn't know I was supposed to take
man,
my
Man, you
time.
Thought wrong, man.
Yeah, but I could whoop it, but in real life, I could beat his ass. In a boxing match for that length of time.
The motherfuckers 1-0 against you. We don't know about that. Last time we heard, the motherfucker knocked you out. The motherfucker won by TKO.
Oh, whoa, he knocked me out?
You was a TKO. The fight didn't go all the way. They stopped it.
No, I was standing up when they stopped it.
Yeah, because that's called TKO, technical knockout. You wasn't asleep.
I could get knocked out with being still awake.
No, you wasn't asleep. Yeah. You wasn't asleep, but let's see, yo. And actually, TKO is worse than getting KO'd. Because a motherfucker could be winning a fight and get caught with one punch and get knocked out. TKO, man, you just getting beat so fucking bad. The referee, hey, yo, you know what? Fuck it. They just pulled the plug on your shit, my son. You had me looking fucked up out there, yo.
Did you lose any clients?
I lost mad clients. I had lost mad clients. You had me looking crazy. Like, I'm the celebrity trainer. I train who?
And you know, the only reason why I chose him too, because he got an eye like mine.
Yeah, you know, so I'm telling you what to do.
Show me how I can survive this.
I can see out my shit, though.
Oh, I ain't know that.
Yeah, I see perfect. Yeah, I'm just lazy.
Oh, okay, well, I shouldn't have been fucking with
my
you.
My shit is like this. you would have had to go get one of the mother motherfuckers or something.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
I got you.
But you don't want a motherfucker that can't see what the fuck you talking about.
Hold on.
No, I see what you're saying.
Hold on. So... did you see all the punches that came from this side?
He felt all them shit.
He
felt
it.
He felt
it. Hey, let me tell you. Olu, you helped me get home. Kenny.
That motherfucker hit Jack so hard, Jack farted.
I did fart. I farted a few times.
I said,
hey,
no lie.
Kenny helped me walk out the building.
Let him know what time it was, Kenny.
How hard was it to get me out of here?
We had to carry this motherfucker.
Yeah.
Like drunk, fucked up?
But he didn't want to listen.
He didn't want to listen. The motherfucker came the day of the fight.
We go to the fight. We always looking. He said, I can do this. I said, I'm not telling you. It's not that hard, man. He said, I can get it. Like, all right. So he getting there. That nigga was laid on the floor and everything.
That motherfucker had y'all there looking crazy.
I didn't walk up and everything.
Yo, but for real, if that shit was in Atlanta, would you be able to go back home? If that shit happened in Atlanta? Would you be able to go back home?
Hey, man, I seen T.I. after that.
Yeah.
I seen T.I.
Yo, speaking of T.I. pissed me off. Snoop pissed me off, too.
No, don't do that. Don't.
Nah, them motherfuckers pissed me off.
Don't do it.
I got to do it.
Man, okay, why tip?
All right, my son Steve Harvey, right, went to go meet with Donald Trump. They say Steve Harvey cooning. We don't know the basis of the conversation. We don't know what went on upstairs. We don't know what they talk about. Meanwhile, Mike Tyson publicly endorsed Donald Trump on the news. They ain't say shit.
Mike will fuck you up.
Exactly.
Mike will fuck you up.
Exactly.
It's easy.
Exactly.
It's
easy. Yeah, yeah, exactly. Michael put his foot up there or teeth in their fucking ear, whichever one. The motherfuckers know how to choose their battle. So we're going to get a Family Feud, nigga.
Yeah,
because this Brownsville motherfuckers or something.
Can I ask you something?
What up?
If you knew a nigga who beat your ass, would you get in the ring with him?
Yeah. Of course. My, you know how many ass whoopers I done got? I'm known for getting my ass whooped. What are you talking about?
And this is where I hide and train.
Yo.
I don't know how many times
niggas get
ass whooped.
Fuck it. Like, come on, son. Andre Ward, I done been in the ring with that. I done beat a lot of motherfuckers,
hold
too.
On. Andre Ward beat your ass?
Yeah, he beat me. I was the number one guy in the U.S., number four in the world. Number one in the U.S. He
Andre beat Ward beat your ass?
I look little. Andre motherfucking Ward whooped my ass.
That ain't no chump down the block. That's
Andre.
Yeah, lost to a motherfucker that got his ass whooped 2 days ago. The nigga had you fresh off an ass whooping.
Hey.
And he used you as a come up.
Hey, this was the worst part of the fight. Worst part of the fight. I'm quitting. I'm quitting the fight.
Yeah.
I said, hey, can you please stop the fight, referee? He said, what?
What the fuck are you talking about?
He said, why? Nigga, I'm about to die. My heart's about to stop.
You about to TKO your motherfuckers up.
My heart is about to stop. I can't move no more, none of that shit.
It was hot as fuck in there, too.
The dude coming towards me, and he hits me in my good eye while I'm quitting.
Yeah.
Everything turned purple. I don't see how to get out the ring now. My whole corner left me in the ring. I was standing in the ring by myself blind.
Niggas started taking pictures and shit. I hurry up and got the fuck out of the ring. I said, nope, you ain't gonna get it. Yeah, man. That
shit
was
crazy. Nigga disowned me after I lost.
Yeah, niggas started taking pictures. I don't want to be there. You know what I'm saying? What I'm gonna do?
Hey, man, look. I
left the motherfucker. Listen, I'll let you know niggas ain't shit, man.
What they call when you're trying to get your title back average the loss?
You're a contender. Right now, you're a contender, and you're trying to get your title back. So right now, you came there with a belt.
Yeah, and I kept my belt, too, because he wanted to take my belt.
Yeah, you should have gave him your fucking belt.
I should have gave him the belt?
Nah, yeah, you came there with a belt.
It wasn't a title fight.
But you came there with the belt.
It wasn't a title fight.
It wasn't a title fight. I knew it was a possibility that I might lose, so I didn't want to put my title
on. I'm saying, but if you go front like a champ, then you got to front like a champ either when you catch that L.
Man,
so you got to give him the belt.
I'm not a real fighter.
Nah, not even a little bit.
I want to get back in the ring. What's up? Will you train me again? And I'm going to come in on time. I'm going to give you them, 8 weeks?
8 weeks.
8 weeks. Let's
That's
do
gonna
it.
Cost you.
I'm gonna give you the money.
Yeah, you motherfucking right now.
I'm gonna give you the money.
You can't fight that, dude. You all right? You
get the money. Hey, man, look at my first 30 seconds. I would have beat your ass.
For 30 seconds, yeah, you probably got it.
I would have beat your motherfucking ass for 30 seconds.
For 30 seconds.
Nobody in this motherfucker want 30 seconds with me. I swear to God. Yo, I swear to God.
Look at this fingernail. You got the prettiest fingernail. Like, I ain't know whether to wrap your hands or put a ring on it.
Hey, man, is there anything you want to say before that bullshit, but we got to
hit me up on Instagram, at Eric Kelly Life, and at Eric Kelly on Twitter. Check me out on Vice, my show on Vice. And, yeah, working with Combate Americas right now on MMA brand, so get your Eric Kelly on.
Boom, party and bullshit.
Party.